Are we recording there?
Yes.
Stealth camp tonight, everybody. I'm running way behind schedule as usual. Just walking the bike up this atrociously big hill. I've got probably another 20 minutes of biking to go. I have a vague idea where my campsite's gonna be. I'm kind of winging it on this one. Don't have much of a plan. I mean, I do have a plan, but it's not really a concrete plan. I got the NEMO Dragonfly one-person bike tent right there. It's first use of this tent. I'll check back in a little bit. I think I really underestimated how long this is gonna take. Like I said, I'm kind of winging it here. That's pretty much all I do is wing it. Lots of bugs. I did bring mosquito repellent. I think I brought everything this time. I don't think I forgot anything. Cranks on my bike are making an atrocious sound. It's really, you know what? It's kind of pissing me off. I gotta figure something out here. I'll report back in a bit. This is horse shit, not bear shit. There could be bears out here. No, it's definitely horses. I know it's a horse.
There's this weird thing in the trees here. I'm not really too sure what it's for. It's very old, whatever it is.
I GPS'd the location prior to coming out here, but I'm actually having a little bit of a hard time finding an accessible way in. As you can see, it's pretty dense bush, and I gotta push my bike through all of that. So what happens when you wing it? You know, it's one of those, like, catch 27 situations or whatever they call it. I'm gonna continue down this trail here, and hopefully there's something that goes off to the left. I gotta check the GPS. Well, I can carry my bike through here and see if there's a clear spot, or I can keep going down the path here. Apparently, simply placing a GPS marker randomly on the map really doesn't work out that well. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not really too sure what to do here. I'm losing daylight. I'm gonna walk down the path just a little bit more and see what I can see. I've decided I'm gonna set the tent up right here. I left the bike back over here. I have to go back and get it. I was just kind of scouting ahead. I guess you'd say I'm gonna leave my camera bag right here. There's nobody around here. Go back to get my bike now. I'm gonna break that branch right there so I know exactly where to come back to. I estimate I have probably half an hour of usable light left. Hopefully I haven't lost my bike. There's actually another spot right over there that would have been good, you know, if the ground was flat. This whole area here is a bit of a flood plane. Lots of animals come through here. I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see some animals tonight. Bike and my pack are way over here. I just left them here just in case I didn't find anything. Oh, and look at that. Apparently my flashlight is on inside my pack. That's cool. Oh no, it's the headlamp, not my flashlight. Okay, well, interesting. Wonder how long that's been on for. All right, let's get this stuff to the campsite. All right, I got everything kind of moved in here. I want to set up the GoPro for a night lapse shot just over that way. But first, I think I'm going to get the tent set up. I have to clean this area up a little bit, get the footprint down, and just pitch the tent.
I think that's what I'm going to do first.
Okay, I just stuck the camera in the tree on the Joby Gorilla Pod. Let's see how this works. I don't know. Winging it. This thing's in the way, isn't it?
Hey, there we go. That's way better.
This is basically where the tent's gonna go. I don't know if I have enough room here. If I had my bivy sack and I did think about bringing the bivy, I would have a lot more options, a lot more places I could camp. I must say the bugs actually aren't that bad. Yeah, I'm losing daylight here really quickly. All right, well, there we go. It's set up.
Here is the campsite for tonight. I'm actually going to move my bike a little bit further into the bushes, probably right here. I think I'm going to clear a little bit of an area here. I'm not sure if I'm going to cook anything tonight because there are possibly bears in the area.
This is obviously not an urban stove camp, but this is within the municipal limits, so it is still technically a stove camp. So once that sun goes down, only red lights. What I'm going to do is when it gets darker, I'm going to change the settings on the camera here. I'm going to go from 60 frames per second to 30 frames per second. That's going to let in quite a bit more light because it's going to get dark out here. There's no street lights. But yeah, it's actually a really nice evening. I have no idea what time it is. It's almost 10 o'clock. It's going to be dark probably in an hour. I'm just going to get the campsite kind of organized here and maybe go for a little wander down over here. I think I see some water over here. We'll see what's over there.
Right here in the landing zone of the tent. This is actually a really cool attachment. I have all of my stuff right there off the ground. I'm gonna zip this up and we're gonna go over in that direction and see what we can see. My tent is right in there. If I zoom in, you'll probably be able to see it. I really like the cool stealth gray kind of bluish color of the fly. It is a beautiful evening out right now. I bought a whole can of bug spray because that's really the only thing that I had. And the bugs, they're not even out. Just gonna walk down here, see what we can see. Plenty more places to camp potentially back in here.
I am definitely coming back out here at the summer solstice. Ah, there is some water up here.
It's like a moose or something coming through here. I would imagine there's quite a few beavers out here. We're definitely gonna have to come out here in the nighttime.
I have no idea how much sleep I'm actually gonna get tonight. It's a pretty common question I get about the stealth camps. How much do you actually sleep? 2 hours, 3 hours, maybe.
Jump! Oh my gosh! Is this like some big giant beaver den right here?
Could be. There could be something living in there.
There's a beaver right there. Look at him. Look at him go. Look at that beaver there. Look at him. Okay, well, here's kind of a panoramic as to where I actually am here. My tent is back over there. But as you can see, there's not a whole lot around here.
Yeah, what a beautiful evening out. If anybody out there in the real world who knows me in real life, if you ever want to come out on one of these camps, you're welcome to come. I got 2-person shelters. I got 3-person shelters.
It's actually starting to get dark pretty quickly. I'm heading back to the tent. In the mud here, there's one other set of footprints, or at least the only one I can find. I don't think very many people come down this way.
I am very interested to see how the $6 Home Depot headlamp that turned on in my backpack happens to work tonight. I think it's going to work just fine.
Can you see my tent right now? It's right in front of you. Walk right up in here, right up to the tent. Bike is back over there. I don't even know if you can see it. I could actually break the rules of stealth camp tonight and have a small fire. I might do that. I don't know.
I think I'm going to get the GoPro set up. I don't know what I'm going to shoot it at. I think just maybe straight out this way and see, maybe get some stars or something. Or maybe I'll go across the clearing here and have it shoot back this way. I don't really know. Anyway, I'm going to set that up right now.
I think right about there looks good. Now, I don't really know how the night lapse is going to look right now because it's still a little bit light out. But we'll see. I'm going to start recording right now. And there we go. It's recording. Come back and pick this up in 2 or 3 hours. We'll have a nice little night lapse to look at. Just walking back to the camp here. I wonder if I can stay connected to the camera if it's too far away. Technology is pretty cool, people.
Yep,
I am still connected to the camera from here. That's good.
I got to get my sleeping pad out and my sleeping bag. Yay, another stuff sack. I always put all of the stuff sacks inside of a single stuff sack. It seems to keep everything really organized. It seems like a good idea. Now, this is supposed to self-inflate, but it doesn't. That's it, she's full.
In there.
Sleeping bag time. I am packing 2 liters of water with me, which does weigh me down quite a bit.
Okay,
that's basically it. We're ready to go to sleep if I want to. Kill this light. Might go for another walk here. Okay, now I'm going to change the camera settings from 60 frames per second to 30 frames per second. It actually makes quite a big difference. I do have to stop filming for this, however. All right, there, we're back at 30 frames per second. You see, it does make quite a big difference. I must say, the one thing I don't like, well, actually, there's many things I don't like about the $6 headlamp. You have to cycle through each mode to turn it off. I keep forgetting that. Well, I'm gonna go out for one final walk here. Not really too sure where I'm gonna go. I might just go back to that big beaver dam. I have to say, I'm shocked that the mosquitoes are not out in full force. Tiny little sliver of the moon in the sky tonight. Very cool. Hey, look at the birds. Look at the birds. Let me zoom in a little bit more. Check that out. That's actually really cool. They flew right in front of the moon. Ha ha! What are the odds of that happening? 1 in 16 trillion billion? Here we got the evening over the water. There's some ducks out there, probably some geese. Lots of birds chirping in the evening time here. It's a beautiful evening. I think I've said that about 17 times. You know, I really don't know why more people don't do this. Well, actually, you know what? I'm not surprised. I found that people, generally, they're not that adventurous. They think that they are, they might think that they are, but they're not really. Some kind of owl thing just flew that way. I don't know if you could see it fly through there or not. I'll have to review that on the footage later on. What's going on over there? I'm gonna have to zoom in on something. There's something across the way here, and that big bird just landed on it. Let's see if I can get it to focus. It's looking right at me. I think it's an owl. Okay, I'm zoomed right in there. Psst, psst, psst. Hey, come here! I'm not being very stealthy right now, am I? Very cool that Mr. Owl is out here watching over me. There's some kind of a party going on over in this direction. Somebody was just launching off some fireworks. That is definitely going to attract a police presence. It's getting pretty dark. I should head back. I'm actually gonna turn this headlamp on. There we go. You know what? This headlamp actually does work pretty well. My hat is kind of screwing up the beam here, but you know what? It's really not a big deal. Yeah, I really can't see anything in these bushes. The hell is my camp at? I can't find my camp here. Yeah, you cannot see this tent at all from over there. It is 100% camouflaged. I walked right past it. All right, we're in night mode now. It's actually getting fairly cold out. It's about 11 o'clock right now. Okay, well, here we are. What to do, what to do? Should I cook something? Should I have a fire? Should I do both? Okay, I think I'm gonna cook some noodles. Pretty quiet out. I can hear people in the background. There actually has been a Sasquatch sighted in this area in 2014. The case was never solved. Anyway, I think I'm gonna cook some noodles. I'm actually pretty hungry. Crap. Remember when I said I thought I remembered everything? I didn't. I hope there's enough gas in here for another boil. Well, we're gonna find out. This is always a pain in the you-know-what to put on. Like, you can get two sides okay. The third just kind of pops over. Pain in the ass. Okay, I got the good Sapporo Ichiban today. Two packs. I hope I have enough fuel here. I don't know. Just break these up. I'm gonna do this a little bit differently this time. I'm gonna actually boil the water first, then I'm going to add the noodles, just like I do on the stove. Oops, I went a little bit over the maximum safe fill line there. I think we'll be okay. Actually, I'm gonna put a little bit more in there. Ha ha ha, there we go. That should be good. That actually, well, pretty good. Slap that lid on there. Now we sit here and wait. I will say this, the white light on this headlamp is actually really good. Okay, we got a little bit of a boil going here. Check out that rolling boil there. All right, I think that's enough. Shut that off. Hang on, let me go to red mode. There we go. Let me turn night shot on too. I don't know if that makes it any better or not. Kind of gives everything kind of an orange type of tinge. I can hear howling behind me. I don't know if it's dogs or if it's coyotes or wolfman. I don't know. Set this aside for now. I think I've cooked these noodles in every stealth camp video I've made. I'm gonna put
both seasoning packs in. Unbelievable. It's like a heart attack waiting to happen. Do you know how much salt that is? It's enough sodium for probably 2 weeks. Oh, here we go. Now I'm just rambling on talking to the camera. I'm telling you, it'd be a lot of fun if someone would come out here with me. Like I said, I am definitely coming back here on the solstice. It's coming up in a week or so. Screw the red light. Okay, let's see here. Needs to sit just a little bit longer, but oh my god, is that good. I'm on the fence about this $6 headlamp. I got it sitting on the ground right now, kind of propped up. These noodles are so friggin' good. I wonder when the party over here is gonna die down. I'm probably gonna pull out of here at around 4 in the morning. The sun will just be coming up around then.
Yeah.
So I'll be lucky if I get 2 hours of sleep. Somebody just lit off another firework. The police gonna come. They won't know I'm here though. This is actually an awesome little spot I found here. I underestimated a lot of things during this stealth camp. I underestimated how long it would take to get here, but I also underestimated the amount of usable light that I had. I had plenty of time to set up my camp. Everything worked out not too pretty bad. Now there is a police helicopter and they do have FLIR on the helicopter. FLIR, of course, being forward looking infrared for people who don't know. So if they wanted to, they could find me. Hopefully they have other things to do tonight. I feel I should correct something that I said earlier. I said that people aren't adventurous. That's not true. Everyone's adventurous in their own way. Not really too sure why I said that. I'm gonna keep it in the video though. This is so salty. It is beyond description. So delicious though. I wonder if this is as dark as it's gonna get. There is a lot of light pollution. I'm really glad I came out here tonight. I wasn't going to. I was gonna put it off another day, but I told someone that I was gonna do it and I said, you know what, I might as well. And to think I wasn't gonna cook anything. But for real, there is a possibility there could be bears out here. Other than the occasional owl hoot, I don't hear anything out here. There's some kind of bird doing something over there. Okay, I think that's about done. I ate the whole friggin' thing, both packs of Ichiban. Must have been hungry or something. I kind of wish I had more, to be honest. Here's a pro tip. When you take a jet boil out and you cook and eat directly out of it, clean it out as soon as you get back. There we go. I'm gonna drink down some water, try and get some of that salt out of my mouth. Well, I'm not really too sure what to do now. Not really tired. Maybe I will build a fire. I don't know. We'll see. Okay, well, I've decided against having a fire because it's midnight right now, and if I'm gonna get any sleep, I should probably just go to bed. I wonder if the microphone's picking that up. Still a lot of people yelling over there. Must be a hell of a party going on. Why wasn't I invited? There's some profanities being thrown around right now. There's probably a fight happening, I have no doubt. I think I'm just gonna wait like another half an hour until the night lapse is done. I'm gonna shut everything off right now. Just kind of chill. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do.
I just thought I would show you guys this. This is what the tent looks like on the outside with a headlamp up in the headlamp pocket. The headlamp is right up in there. And yeah, you can see it's lighting up everything. This is what it looks like here with the red light on. I'm not really too sure if you can even see it there. The red light on this particular headlamp is not very bright though. But still, the light footprint is considerably less. I thought that would be a pretty cool thing to show you guys.
Okay, getting in to the tent now. Have all of my stuff right there in the landing zone, organized, ready to go tomorrow.
Or in a few hours, I should say.
This is the light pocket I was talking about. You just set the headlamp right up in there, and it lights up the entire interior of the tent. I better zip this down before all these bugs decide to come in.
I find you can zip it down a lot easier than zipping it up. I mean, yeah, you can't see anything. I'm sorry, people.
Getting ready for bed. Jacket is gonna be my pillow. It's not gonna work worth a damn, but whatever. I actually previewed the night lapse that I took. It sucks. So what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to deal with this shot of me zooming in and out of the moon. That's all I got. Everybody, I'm going to sleep for a couple hours. I'll catch you in the morning. Thank you.
got here?
3:30 in the morning.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Okay, I think I only got maybe an hour's sleep. It shouldn't take me any more than half an hour to pack everything up out of here. I want to get out of here pretty quick before the dog walkers start coming through here.
Oh, man.
Okay. Guess I better start figuring this out, eh?
Oh, it's actually pretty cold out.
Start deflating the air mattress. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my sleeping bag away.
Down.
It should, in theory, go into the stuff sack, no problem.
You know what, actually? That went in incredibly easy.
A little too easy, actually.
Alright, let's get out of the tent.
It is a frosty morning out here.
You see, the sun is actually starting to come up. Actual sunrise is until about 5:20. Sunrise, of course, being when the solar disk comes up over the horizon. Yeah, I gotta get this whole thing all struck here. I'm just gonna get to it.
Hopefully this fits in the bag.
Well, it has to fit. There's no option. It literally has to fit.
Okay, where's that stuff sack at?
This tent is very easy to pack away. And bam, the bike tent is packed up, ready to go.
Just gotta pack up the footprint. I could have packed the footprint with the tent itself.
I'm really not too sure why I didn't.
Obviously wasn't thinking again.
See, my problem is I'm trying to do this properly.
Come on, get in there. All right, there we go. Footprint is packed away.
Now all I have to do is I have to attach the tent to the handlebar, and I'm pretty much ready to go. I got the tent on the handlebars. I just have to put the tripod away, get my camera bag all squared away. I'm gonna drink some water here and then navigate out in this direction here. It's still pretty dark, but I'll figure it out. Well, I made it back to this trail here. I don't want to call this the main trail because it's not. Navigating out wasn't too difficult. It's still pretty dark out. The birds are definitely starting to come out. I just follow this path pretty much all the way out of here. I'm definitely coming back here for the summer solstice. Like I said, if anybody out there in real life wants to come with me, you're more than welcome to.
Are we focused? Are we? I think so.
Oh my god, I am tired. I've got about a half an hour bike ride home.
I'm just gonna take it leisurely, you know? I'm not in any rush. Kinda wish I had another layer on, though.
I would say I'm dressed bare minimum for the conditions right now. I'm really glad that I came out and did this stealth camp tonight. Like I said before, I wasn't gonna do it, but I'm really glad that I did. I was gonna put it off another day. Don't put things off. I wanna thank all of you out there for watching this video. I sure hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for the summer solstice stealth camp. Try saying that 3 times fast. Hold your head up high out there, everybody. Never look down the ground. I will catch all of you out there on the next video. You know it will be absolutely awesome. See ya!